that are next before tonight's semi.
Steve, it's obviously a very tough life being a top darts player.
I must be looking very good.
How pleased are you with your performances so far?
Very pleased, actually, very pleased. And so we can carry on playing well now.
Obviously, meeting Dennis Priestley must have given you a huge boost.
Obviously, the world's number one. I mean, it's great. And then Bob the other night, I mean, that's even better then.
Having played so well, is there a reason for that? Can you put your finger on why it's all come good for you at the right time?
I don't really know. I mean, I've always been playing well. It's just put it all together for that one week, you know. I mean, a few competitions I've been close a couple of times, and you know, you miss your doubles and that lot. But when you can put it all together and play well consistently, you're a great filter, aren't you?
You've obviously got some support as well on the table, your fiancé and Annette. And you're a player as well, Annette, aren't you? Yeah, a serious one too.
Very, not as good as him now. I'll play well against him.
You do actually play against each other then, yeah? So do you win a few?
Sometimes, yeah, a few.
So what about the match against Alan Warner then? How do you see it going?
Hopefully Buddy Button play as well as I have been played, and hopefully try to take the first couple of sets and get in first, really.
That seems to be part of the secret, doesn't it? Get off to a good start because you've done that both the matches so far.
Really, yeah. If you can get straight into the game and try to take the first couple of sets, yeah.
And if you get to the final on the net, would you be able to bring yourself to one?
No. If anybody cracks this week, it'd be me, not him.
Surely the first ever interview with a darts player, which took place in a jacuzzi. Well, one of...